Okay, so my question for you to now talk to your neighbor for a second is, why do you think some women struggle to have orgasm? Like, most people don't talk about it being super difficult, although it can be, but not in general. When we look at a population, we don't talk about, you know, difficulty with a man having orgasm, but we do sometimes talk about difficulty with a female having orgasm. Let's talk to your neighbor and see if you can come up with one or two reasons why that might be the case. So there's actually science behind the all mental thing, right? So we'll get there in a second, but there are parts of your brain that, when they've done actual studies to look at what areas of your brain light up, there are areas of your brain that need to quiet down. And that if those areas don't quiet down, they do not see people leading to arousal or orgasm. So when we say, like, it's all in their head, no, actually, it's their brain not shutting down in the areas that it should, right? Now, I can, as a woman with a child and a busy career and whatnot, I can come up easily with reasons why my brain doesn't want to just shut off all of a sudden magically. So it's a good idea to, you know, help somebody get to the place where their brain is ready to shut down, but there is reason for that. There's actual science behind it. So again, I'll get there in a second. But does anyone else have another idea why that might have more to do with the physical anatomy or something like that? Someone have an idea? Yes.
It's not like all of the nerve endings, I mean, sure, they're all located on the clip, but there's also the spread of everywhere. Have you ever seen that GIF image that was floating around the internet where it's all these knobs and dials with women underneath it and then the on-off switch for men?
For men, yes. I have.
So I think that maybe for some women it's really easy to get fed up with how much goes into figuring it out initially, so that then there's more practice.
That's a really great way to describe that. And I'm not sure if everyone heard the image that's gone around that I've definitely seen, where it's got like the box with like all the dials and everything, and that's women, and then there's the man, and it's like on. But maybe it does take a little bit of learning. It does take a little bit of figuring out, well, where are these sensations coming from and why, and how do I even feel about that? And actually, that leads me to where I was semi-going with my first thought here. Here's a statement right out of, this is Masters and Johnson is one of the groups that spent a lot of time. If you've read the book, Mary Roach's book, Bonk, she uses their information quite a bit. But this is back even in 1966. So here, in direct manipulation of the clitoris, they always talk very sciencey. In direct manipulation of the clitoris, there is a narrow margin between stimulation and irritation, right? Meaning that area, that glands, especially if someone has really never learned any other part of the anatomy, that in some ways this one teeny area has a lot of nerve endings, and that therefore it can go in the wrong direction, as in there's so much nerve endings and so much information that it's not pleasurable, it's irritating, right? So again, that would be a time where a woman might say, no, stop, go away, I don't like this, it's not working for me, right? And again, the degree of friction might go along with that, and thus I'll put the plug in for the 3 to 5 orgasms using oral sex before. But I'll just throw that out there one more time. Because that may decrease the amount of irritation when you have an area of skin that is so highly sensitized, right? So that's one of the reasons, potentially. Let's get another couple of thoughts up here. When they've collected data, it appears that only 20 to 30% of women will report orgasm during intercourse. Okay, another plug for why before. So only 20 to 30% during intercourse. Now, if you remember the anatomy that I just shared, a lot of the female anatomy that has these nerve endings is exterior. It's not nerve endings within the vaginal area, and therefore not all women, as you can see from this data, will report that that's the time that they have the greatest degree of orgasms, especially if there's been nothing preceding. So there has been a debate, again, in the literature about if, you know, can you have a vaginal orgasm, or all orgasms need to be from the clitoris, and you can imagine it's a little tricky to study this. and get human subjects approval. But it's being done. People are studying this, thank goodness, because how are we supposed to learn about our bodies unless we get this information? So, but there is debate about this, and some authors will state strongly that there is no such thing as a vaginal orgasm, meaning that any orgasm occurs is because some of the area of the clitoris that we talked about or some other external genitalia is being stimulated during the process of intercourse, and that's what's leading to an orgasm for those 20 to 30 people. So anyway, kind of fun little debate to read in the literature, if you enjoy it. But, you know, again, I'll just make one more plug. You don't want to wait.